Hi everyone. Today we will discuss about construction of steering geometry. It is a new topic in steering system. In yesterday's class, we will start a new unit. It is Unit 3, Steering System in Automobile Engineering subject. In yesterday's class, we will discuss about the introduction of steering system. So in the introduction, we will know about the what is steering system and what is the introduction of steering system, what is the principle of steering system, what are the different principal components are assembled in a steering system, what type of mechanisms are used in the steering system, what are the different types of gears used in steering system, and what type of motion conversion in that steering system. These are all topics we will see in yesterday's class. Today we will see about what is the construction of steering geometry. So in that construction, there are different parts we are using. So in that overall steering geometry, we will show in this class some components. We will show some components we should discuss in this class. First of all, you can see what is the introduction of this steering geometry. The steering system allow the driver to control the direction of vehicle travel. So the steering system, it is allowed to controlling the vehicle of driver. So the driver should control the vehicle by using one geometry, one system. That system is called a steering system. If we take any type of or almost all type of automobile vehicles, it is a steering geometry. Steering system. So it is the three wheelers or four wheelers or six wheelers, 10 wheelers, 8 wheelers, those different types of automobile vehicle, they placed a steering system. So in that steering system, there are different types of steering systems are available. So in further classes, we will discuss about those types of steering systems also. So mainly, what is the purpose of that steering system in automobile vehicle is the driver to control the direction of the vehicle. So the driver to control the vehicle by using steering system. The following are the secondary function of steering system. It provides directional stability of vehicle when going straight ahead. So the following are the secondary functions of steering system. These are all secondary functions. It provides directional stability vehicle when going to straight ahead. So the vehicle moves a straight path on the road. So the road is straight. The vehicle also moves straight. The road has any type of directions. It is left side or right side directions. Whenever we go the left side or right side, automatically the steering system are used to turn the vehicle. It provides straight ahead recovery after completing a turn. So the turning is completed. So in the turning, I am using steering system to take a turning. On that it is the left side or right side or any type of direction, the steering system used to turn that vehicle. After completion of the turning, the vehicle runs straight away on that road. It helps in controlling wear and tear of tires. So the steering system are mainly used, the main application it is to control the wear and tear resistance of the tires. And it converts the rotary movement of the steering wheel into an angular turn of the front wheels. The steering is rotary motion. The steering should be that the steering is in the hands of driver. So the driver should rotate that steering. So in that rotatory motion, finally converted into sliding motion of that angular turn of the front wheels. That is the motion conversion in the steering system. It is the introduction of the steering geometry. So you can know what is steering system. The steering system is the term applied to the collection of components, linkages, which will allow a vehicle to follow the desired directions. And an automobile is steered with the help of steering gears and linkages, which transfer the motion of hand-operated steering wheel to the pivoted front wheel hubs via steering column. So steering is the term applied to the collection of components. Those are different components are assembled and form a one geometry, one assembled component. So those different components are connected and forming only one geometry. That geometry is called steering system. So in that components, there are different components and different gears, different linkages are used to assemble and form a steering system, which will allow a vehicle to follow the desired directions. So the steering system, we can rotate that steering system to operate the overall vehicle. So the overall vehicle direction should go through that only on steering system. Steering system should, the steering should operate turn right side. Automatically the steering turn right side, the overall vehicle should turn right side of that road. So overall vehicle is based upon the steering system. An automobile is steered with the help of steering gears, linkages, which transfer the motion of hand operated steering wheel to the pivoted front wheel hubs via steering column. So in that automobile, steered with the help of how the steering will be works. It is based on the different types of components are involved in that steering system. Different geometry is placed, different mechanisms are used, different linkages are used. Based upon those linkages, those components, the overall steering system should works. So the steering gears and linkages which transfer the motion. The steering motion should be transferred by using these steering gears and linkages, which transfer the motion of the hand operated steering wheel to the pivoted front wheel hubs via steering column. So this steering system is pivoted to the front wheels of the vehicle via pivoting or different joints are used to join that steering system and front wheel axle. Okay. Next, the other parts that are used for steering a vehicle are steering wheel pads, steering shafts, steering boxes, steering arms, and steering stabilizers. These are different parts are assembled in the steering system. So a vehicle steering has a wheel pads, steering shafts, steering boxes, steering arms. These are also different components in the steering system. These parts are made of durable materials. How should manufacture and what type of materials used to manufacture these type of components in steering system? So these parts are made of durable materials like stainless steel, iron, aluminium, copper, magnesium, titanium, platinum, rubber, and plastics. Those are the different materials are used to manufacture these type of components. And next one, what are the following requirements of a good steering system? What requirements should be taking to manufacture this steering system, and what type of different components, what are the requirements taking, what are the different specifications should follow to manufacture these different components in the steering system. So what are the main requirements of a good steering system? The steering mechanism should be very accurate and easy to handle. So it is the main thing in the steering system, just the rotation of the steering system, automatically the front wheels of the vehicle, it will be sliding. So the mechanism, the steering mechanism is very simple to handle overall vehicle. Okay, that is the first one, first requirement. And second one, the vehicle should be steered with minimum of effort so that the driver does not feel driving fatigue. So the vehicle should be steered with a minimum effort. Only the minimum amount of effort should be placed on that steering. Automatically, the vehicle should run easily. The vehicle should turn easily at different turnings on that roads. So the driver put a some amount of effort only. The driver should not put any high amount of efforts to turn that vehicle. Okay, so that is also one requirement of the good steering system. The steering mechanism should be affected by the side thrusts, cornering forces, and wind effects. So the steering mechanism, so we are using different types of steering mechanisms. What type of steering mechanism should be placed in that steering system? It is not affected to the side thrust and cornering faces and wind effects. These are the effects of the steering system. So we can should avoid these type of side thrusts and cornering faces and wind effects. We should accurately fix this steering system and it should move freely on the vehicle. So that is also one requirement. And next one, the mechanism should have a tendency to regain the straight ahead configuration after steering need is over. So the mechanism should have a tendency to regain that straight ahead after turning. So the vehicle on a road, the vehicle runs on a road, suddenly it will take a turning on that road. Automatically the steering should take the straight path of that road. So the turning should automatically convert into, without any effort placed on the driver on that steering system, automatically the steering should take the straight path on that road. So these are the different requirements of the good steering system. And what is the purpose of steering system in automobile vehicle? The primary purpose of a steering system is to allow the driver to guide the vehicle. So that is the purpose. Only the direction should be giving that steering system is driver. So the driver is giving the directions to that steering system. In nowadays, so many automatic steering systems are available. Once we can place a path on that panel, it will automatically guide the overall vehicle and runs the vehicle by using so many automatic type of cars available in the market. Next, the system includes the following: the steering wheel, which the driver controls. So the steering wheel in the control of driver, and the steering gears, which changes the rotary motion of a wheel into a straight line motion. The steering gear is used to change the rotary motion of a wheel into a straight line motion of the vehicle. And the steering linkages, which transmits the steering gear movement to the front wheels. So the steering linkages, these links are used to transmits the steering gear movement to the front wheels. So the steering should rotate it is left direction or right direction, automatically that rotation should be transferred by using these linkages in the sliding motion of the wheels in the automobile vehicle. So these are the purpose of the steering system. And what are the functions of a steering system? So the functions of the steering system, it controls the front wheel, sometimes rear wheel directions also control the steering system. Transmit road feel, the slight steering wheel pull caused by the road surface to the driver's hand. Maintain correct amount of effort needed to turn the wheels. It absorbs the shocks going to the steering wheels as the tire hits the holes and bumps in the road, allow for suspension action. these are the different functions of the steering system. These functions we already discussed in a previous class. Okay, so what is the layout of a steering system? So what is the layout and what are the different components placed in that system? What are the different parts involved in that steering system? You can see a typical steering system consists of steering wheel, steering shaft, steering gearbox, pitman arm, drag link, steering knuckle arm, tie rod, track rod arm. These are all different components are involved in the steering system. That's why it is the these are the layout of a steering system. In that layout, you can see there are different components involved. These different components are assembled to form one steering system. Okay. You can see what are the these what are the different components are fixed in that front wheel axle of the automobile vehicle. So the tie rod is fixed on the suspension systems also, and there is a gearbox. In the gearbox, the linkages are connection. The rotary motion is converted into a sliding motion of the front wheels of the automobile vehicle. So in this purpose, there are different types of gears are used to change that motion, and there is a pitman arm. It is the pitman arm to connect the gearboxes and the linkages, and there is a drag link and a steering arm. These are the different parts in the steering system. So turning the car. So to turn the car, when the turning, front wheels don't point to the direction. So the point of direction of the front wheel, it is not same axis. The front wheels axis is different compared to rear wheels of the automobile vehicle. Inside wheel turns at a smaller radius, hence the inside wheel turns at a steeper angle than the outside wheel. You can see the outside wheels of the automobile vehicle. This automobile vehicle, the vehicle is in at a turning moment. So the vehicle is in turning position. So the vehicle turns on a road. Automatically, the front wheels and back wheels are also turning motion, but in the outside wheel, means the back wheels of the vehicle, the wheels axis is at same point. The wheel axis is at only same point. The wheel axis is only same point. Okay, same axis is applied on that back wheels of the automobile vehicle, and you can observe the front wheels of the automobile vehicle. It is at a turning moment. The axis of the front wheels is different. The axis of the front wheels is different. You can see the center of turning circle. In the center of turning circle, the back wheels axis is same, and the front wheel axis are different. Okay, so that is the turning car. When turning car, front wheels don't point to the same direction. Next one, linkage of steering system. So in that linkage of steering system, there are different gears are used to connect this steering system by using different gears. He can use worm gear. So the worm gear are used to connect that rotatory steering system. That rotatory steering system, there is a steering wheel. It is a steering wheel. It is the steering wheel. Steering wheel. And the next one, in that steering wheel, it is connected with a steering shaft. Steering shaft. That steering wheel is connected with steering shaft. That steering shaft is connected with the one gear. So that gear is called recirculating ball gearbox. In that recirculating ball gearbox, a worm gear is connected to convert the motion of that steering wheel. Okay, so and that worm gear is connected through the pitman arm. This pitman arm is connected through the track rod and tie rod. Track rod and tie rod. So the pitman arm is connected to the track rod. And the track rod moves in the direction of front wheel. Automatically, the wheels are activating through this connection of pitman arm from the steering wheel. Whenever we rotate that steering wheel, automatically the wheels are also sliding motion, slided by using different types of mechanism. So that is the linkage of steering system. You can see these, the tie rod, track rod, pitman arm, tie rod, and a recirculating ball gear boss. There are the different components in the linkage of steering system. Okay. And next you can see what are the different constructional details and what are the components involved in this steering system. Is one of the component, one of the main component is camber. So first of all, you can see what is camber and where we place that camber position and what is the effect of camber. What is the working of camber? You can see camber is the tilt of the car wheel from the vertical. So camber is the tilt of the car wheel from the vertical. You can see the arrow mark direction. You can see the arrow mark direction. So the load acting on the road. So how should the tire is fixed on the front axle? How should we fix the tire on the front axle? And what type of load is acting on the road? What is the vertical reference? And where we fix that tire on the road? Front axle. There are two types of camber. It is a positive camber angle and a negative camber angle. Positive camber angle and negative camber angle. You can see camber is the tilt of the car wheel from the vertical. So the wheel is not fixed on the vertical direction. It is not fixed at a 90 degrees angle. Okay, so the tire life will be maximum when camber angle is zero. So we can increase the tire life. We can increase the tire life. It will be maximum. The tire life will be maximum. We can put the camber angle is zero. We can put the camber angle is zero. Then we can place that camber angle is zero. Automatically the tire life will be increased. And caster is also known as wheel rake. That is wheel rake angle. Wheel rake angle. Wheel rake angle. And next, what is the effect? It is excessive camber causes improper contact of the wheel. So excessive camber causes. What is the effect of camber we place on the automobile vehicles? It is excessive camber causes improper contact of the wheel. So the contact of the wheel and the road, it is not proper contact between this wheel and road. That's why the running of the vehicle it gets some speed reduction or power losses. These are different errors or different drawbacks are getting this type of camber placed on the automobile vehicle wheels. Okay. And next, amount. Most manufacturers specify a small camber. Most manufacturers specify a very small camber, usually 2 degrees to 3 degrees from straight up and down. So most manufacturers specify a very small camber. So they cannot put camber angle zero, or they cannot put that is vertical direction. The camber angle is 90 degrees. They will not put. So they can maintain the camber angle. It is usually 2 degrees to 3 degrees. So this amount of angle should be maintained in the tires of the automobile wheels. Okay. Next one, you can see what is positive camber angle and what is the negative camber angle. So the positive camber angle have if tires outward, it is a positive camber angle. Positive camber angle primarily used on front wheels. Reasons to use positive cambers, S type of tires are used in this positive camber angle. Okay, so you can see that positive camber angle. If tiles outward, it is positive camber angle. The tiles, it is in the position of outward. You can see it is the positive direction. It is the positive direction and it is the negative direction. You can see the how the tire should be placed. So tire is positioned in this direction. Tire is placed in this direction. This positive direction. In this direction, the tire is fixed. Okay, that is the positive camber angle. That fixing is called positive camber angle. Okay, so it is the vertical direction. It is the vertical direction of wheel. So in that vertical direction of wheel, place 90 degrees, but we can maintain only the 2 degrees of camber angle, 2 or 3 degrees of camber angle. Okay, so that is the positive direction of camber angle. And what is the negative direction of camber angle? So if tilted inward, it is negative camber angle. Negative camber angle primarily used on rear wheels. So the negative camber angle is used on rear wheels, and the positive camber angle is used in front wheels of the automobile vehicle. What are the reasons to use negative camber angle? Increased cornering ability and increased road shock and component wear. These are the reasons are negative cambers used in the automobile vehicles in rear wheels. You can see the what is the corner angle? It is the vertical position of the tire. It is either 0 degrees or 90 degrees. It will not put in the 0 degrees or 90 degrees. It will tilt that angle. That is 2 degrees angle or 3 degrees angle should be maintained on the automobile wheels. Okay, so in this negative camber are used in rear wheels of the automobile vehicle. The corner increased the cornering ability and increases road shocks and component wear. These are the advantages of the negative camber angle used in the rear wheels of the automobile vehicle. And next one, next component, caster. Next thing, caster. The angle between the kingpin center line and the vertical in the plane of the wheel is called caster angle. You can observe what is caster. The angle between the kingpin center line. It is the kingpin center line. It is the kingpin center line. It is the kingpin. So it is the kingpin center line. In this kingpin center line and the vertical in the plane of wheel. This is the vertical plane. So vertical plane, this angle is called a caster angle. Suppose the caster pin placed in this direction. The caster pin placed in this direction. So it is the angle in this direction. The angle is in this direction. Okay, so the vertical in the plane of wheel. So it is the wheel. It is the circular wheel. So this circular wheel plane is it is the vertical plane of the wheel. So the angle between this caster pin and vertical plane of the wheel, so that is the angle, that angle is called caster angle. Okay, so what is the effect we placed in this caster angle? Incorrect caster can produce difficulties like hard steering, pulling to one side when brakes are applied. So that is the effect of the caster angle. So incorrect caster can produce difficulties like hard steering. It will get hard steering placed a caster angle on the automobile vehicle steering system, and difficulties like hard steering, pulling to one side when brakes are applied. We will apply the brake at one side, it will applied on the other side of the vehicle. So these are the effects are getting in this caster angle. What is the amount? It will be about 3 degrees. So the caster angle is about 3 degrees we should maintain in the automobile vehicle steering system. Okay, what is the positive caster angle and negative caster angle? So you can see what is the angle. It is, the caster is called positive when the top of the kingpin axis inclined to the rear wheel of the wheel. So benefits of the positive caster: helps to maintain directional stability, helps to return wheels to straight ahead after being steered. These are the benefits of the positive caster angle placed in the automobile vehicles. You can observe what is the positive caster angle. So the angle should be placed in the direction of positive. The caster is called positive when the top of the link, that is kingpin axis, is inclined to the rear wheel. So inclined to the rear wheel. So these are the front wheel in the, it is the front wheel direction, and it is the front wheel. Okay, you can observe it is the front wheel, and in the direction of it is the rear wheel. So the kingpin is placed in the direction of rear wheel, in the direction of rear wheel. And the kingpin is placed in this direction. In this, that means a clockwise direction. You can place a clockwise direction of the kingpin, that is rear wheel direction, and it is also called as positive caster angle. Okay, so we can place in this positive caster angle in automobile vehicles. What are the different benefits? It is, it helps to maintain directional stability, and it helps to return wheels straight ahead after being steered. Okay, so these are the benefits of the positive caster angle. And what is negative caster angle? If topping of the kingpin axis is inclined to the front of the vehicle, so it is inclined to the front of the vehicle, front side of the vehicle wheels. So you can observe what is the front side of the vehicle wheels. In this direction, it is the negative direction. Okay, it should not in the position of rear wheel direction. It is in the direction of front wheel direction. Okay, so in this direction, the angle is called, this kingpin angle is also called negative caster angle. What are the benefits of this negative caster angle? Is wheel is easier to turn. So the wheel is easy to turn on the roads. Okay, that is the advantage of the negative caster angle. And next one, kingpin inclination. What is the inclination of a kingpin? The angle between the vertical line and the center of the kingpin or steering axle when viewed from front vehicle is known as kingpin inclination. The angle between the vertical line and the center of the kingpin, it is the vertical line. It is the axis line, and it is the center vertical line. You can see it is the vertical line. Okay, it is the vertical line. So the angle between the vertical line and the center of the kingpin, you can see it is the center of the kingpin. It is the center of the kingpin and it is the vertical line. So the angle between the vertical line and the center line of the kingpin, it is called steering axle, or when we can view the front view of the vehicle, is known as kingpin inclination. This angle is known as kingpin inclination. What is the effect of this kingpin inclination? It is reduces steering effort, particularly when vehicle is stationary. It reduces tire wear also. So the vehicle is in stationary, the vehicle is at rest position, the vehicle is at stationary, it will affect the tires. Okay, that has some wear resistance occurred in the stationary position of wheels. And what is the amount? The kingpin inclination in vehicle ranges from 6 to 8 degrees. So we can maintain the kingpin inclination, it is 6 to 8 degrees. It must be equal to both sides. You can observe, there is the camber. What is camber? What is caster? Front of axle. And what is the toe distance in the wheel axle? Okay. And next one, toe in and toe out. Toe in is the amount of which the front wheels are set closer together at the front than at the rear. You can see the directions. The front wheels are those wheels. Are in positive direction. Those wheels are in positive direction. The length of the front is decreased and compared to the rear. The back end of the wheels. The distance between the two wheels, back end is high and the front end is lower. Okay, so toe is in the amount of the front wheels are set closer together the front than at the rear. When the vehicle is stationary, front is 79 inches and rear is 80 inches. Total toe in is 1 inch. So that amount of values we will maintain in the automobile vehicle. And next one, what is a toe out? So the wheel may be set closer at the rear than the front, in which the difference of the distance between the front wheels and the front and the rear is called toe. You can observe only the wheels in negative direction. The front end of the wheel is maximum distance and the back end of the wheel is very small distance. Okay, so the front is 80 inches, the rear is 79 inches, the total toe out is 1 inch. Okay, you can observe the diagram. What is the toe in and out? Toe in and toe out. So it is the toe in and it is the toe out. You can observe the wheels, the wheel, the front end of the wheel, the distance between this front end of the wheels is one direction, and next one, the back end of the wheels is high in compared to the front end of the wheel. It is 79 inches and it is 80 inches. And it is the back end of the wheel 79 inches and front end of the wheel is 80 inches. That is toe out. That is the difference between the toe in and toe out. Okay. So it is the construction of the steering system. In next class, we will discuss a new topic in this steering system. Thank you. Thank you, guys.